Hello and welcome to Puar Academy. We are learning index numbers and now this is turn of the index number, the most awaited index number, and that is Fisher's Price Index or Fisher's Ideal Price Index. Yes, Professor Irving Fisher, the well-known American economist. Yes. First of all, let's rethink briefly about Laspeyre and Passe, the index number suggested by Laspeyre and Passe. Yes, the main thing in Laspeyre index number is to consider the quantity of the base year. On the basis of the summation of these two columns, we can easily calculate Laspeyre's index number. And in case of Passe, the highlight is considering quantity of the current year. In case of Lasse, considering quantity of base year, and in case of Passe, considering quantity of current year. That are the highlight points. Now, even as a student studying this first time, in case of Laspeyre, we can say that why only the quantity of base year? And in case of Passe, why only the quantity of current year? Obviously, both are different according to the purchasing power, according to the supply available in market, according to the changes in price and the relationship between price and supply, demand and supply, etc., etc. We can easily say that in the real market, quantity consumed by the customers or consumers in the base year and in the current year are not the same. Otherwise, if the quantity in both the years are same, then there should not be the two different index numbers. Yes? So, why only of 1 year? Laspeyre suggested the consideration of quantity of base year only, and Passe current year only. So, both gave emphasis to the different quantities. Doesn't it create any bias considering only quantity of base year or only quantity of current year? Yes, this thing creates bias in calculating and in the ultimate result of the index numbers. And technically, these are called positive bias in case of Laspeyre's index number, or upward bias. Technically, the economic philosophers say that in case of Laspeyre, we can say that there is positive price bias or upward bias, and in case of Passe, there is negative price bias or downward price bias. I don't want to go deep inside these two or four terms, because it is not in the scope of you people, the students of higher secondary or standard 12 or under graduation. But this thing creates bias. Considering the quantity of only 1 year, either of the base year or current year, creates bias. Now, how to get rid of this kind of bias? How to remove the effect of this kind of bias? If we put into simple words, this thing into simple words. Yes, Fisher in 1921, while presenting a paper in a conference, suggested a new technique. And because of so many points raised by him, his index number is called ideal index number. And the first thing, or rather first reason behind calling his index number as ideal index number is, Fisher's index number corrects the positive bias or upward bias of the Laspeyre's index number, as well as the negative price bias or downward bias of Passe's index number. Yes, and number two is, he suggested calculating the price index by geometric mean. But the important thing is, geometric mean of what? Yes. He didn't deny taking base year quantity or current year quantity. he suggested considering quantities of both the years. Because, so in other words, we can say that he suggested to consider both the realities while calculating the index number for the current year. And now if we consider quantity of base year as well as quantity of current year, then it is sometimes like a combination of last pairs and past pairs index numbers. Yes, it is. Because ultimately Fisher suggested that we should take the geometric mean of last pairs index number and past pairs index number as the final price index number. Yes. So, if you have already studied this chapter in your class or in your online class of school or college, your teacher must have said that Fisher's index number is the geometric mean of last pair's index number and Passer's index number. Yes, this is really. Now, first of all, technically, what is geometric mean? Geometric mean means if we multiply n number of items and get its nth root, that is called geometric mean of n items. There are two items A and B, two numbers A and B. If we multiply A and B, then we have to take its square root to get its geometric mean. So this is geometric mean of A and B. Similarly, if we have three items A, B and C, then its geometric mean will be cube root of product of A, B and C, and so on. We have two index numbers, last pair's index number and passes index number. So we have to take the square root only. So officially, Fisher's index number is geometric mean of last pair's index number and passes index number. So on the basis of these two index numbers, we can calculate the Fisher's index number without going through this kind of statistics. But subject to the condition that we should have last pairs and passes index number correctly calculated. Now, for the students especially, how to calculate Fisher's index number? If in your assignment or homework or examination, you are asked to calculate Fisher's index number only, then you have to calculate the Fisher's index number. Rather, you can calculate the Fisher's index number in two ways. First, calculate last pair's index number, then calculate passes index number, and then calculate the Fisher's index number as geometric mean of these two. This technique is useful in all the two cases where separately last pair's, passes, and Fisher's index number are asked, or where only calculation of Fisher's index number is necessary. But if where there is, say, where there you are required to calculate Fisher's index number only, then you can directly calculate Fisher's index number by substituting all these values into formula. And my suggestion is, if you need to calculate only Fisher's index number, then don't go for calculation of last pair's index number and passes index number. Try directly calculating Fisher's index number. Because as a student as well as a teacher, I have seen some students making mistake in calculating either last pair's index number or passes index number, or in case of both, and then calculating Fisher's index number. That means if you make error in calculating last pair's index number or passes index number or both, then automatically you will calculate the wrong index number, rather Fisher's index number. Yes, if you have made mistake in any one, two or both of last pairs and passes index number, then your Fisher's index number will also be wrong. So when you need to calculate only Fisher's index number, write the whole formula and substitute all these four summations into that formula and find out Fisher's index number directly. Don't go for calculating last pair's index number and passes index number if you are not required to give these two as your final answers. I want to save your time as well as you people from making error, or say bearing the results, or rather say fruits of the error you have already made in calculating either last payer or past payer or both the index numbers. This is, I am telling on the basis of my experiences as student when I was studying, as well as a teacher when I was teaching in colleges. So, see, in this case, we need to calculate Fisher's index number only. So, I would prefer calculating Fisher's index number by the full formula. Sigma P1Q0 divided by sigma P0Q0. You can say this O or 0, anything, because in India students tell either 0 or O. I leave it to you. Then sigma P1Q1 upon sigma POQ1. And then multiply the whole result by 100. Let's substitute the values 2040.9 in the place of sigma P1QO, then in the place of sigma P0Q0 take 1610.55 into sigma P1Q1, that is 3180.25, and sigma POQ1 2507.15. Somewhat longer process, but it saves you from bearing the results of error in case of last pair or passes index number. I don't tell that every time everybody will make the mistake, but I am trying to save you people from a probable error. One of the thousands can make this error. If one of the thousand can make the error, that can be you also. That's why I am trying to save you from that kind of error. Yes? Okay. Oh yeah, it will be, yes, you can use calculator, 1.2672 into 1.2685 and into 100. Yes? So it is ultimately 1.6074. Yes, multiplication of these two, 1.6074. We have to multiply the square root of these by 100. Its square root comes to 1.2678, multiplied by 100. So ultimately, Fisher's index number for this particular data comes to 126.78. Now, you have already watched my previous two lectures, or rather my previous four lectures, and you know very well that how to calculate last pair's index number. We have already calculated last pair's index number for this particular data. You also know that how to calculate passes index number, and we have already calculated passes index number for the same data. Yes, now we have calculated Fisher's index number for the same data. If you go through the two lectures in which we learned to calculate last pair's index number as well as passes index number, then from your notebook get the final answers of those two index numbers. Yes. Find out the final answers of those two index numbers. They were 126.72 and 126.85. Yes, it will be 160.74, and ultimately the square root of that will come to 126.78. See, by both the formulae, this is nothing, this can be said as shortcut formula in the case where we have already calculated last pair index number and past index number. Otherwise, you can directly calculate Fisher's index number through this formula. Yes, so in this lecture, we learned how to calculate Fisher's index number directly from the data, as well as after calculating last pair index number and past index number. I hope this lecture is also very useful to you. Yes, in the way, same way as my previous lectures are useful. So don't forget to like this lecture. Don't forget to visit and subscribe my YouTube channel PRSHNTPUAAR. But my new title of my channel is PUAAR Academy, PUAAR Academy. Yes, on YouTube, my channel is with the name, with the title PUAAR Academy, but I run this through my ID PRSHNTPUAAR. So in search bar, you can directly write PRSHNTPUAAR. And don't forget to recommend my channel to all others. Yes, this my channel is helpful to you, all of the people who are interested in knowing something. There are so many chapters of statistics, operations research, operations management, costing, etc. And I am gradually, say, increasing the number of lectures there on my channel. So please subscribe as well as recommend. That's it. Thank you very much and take care of yourself and your loved ones. Bye-bye.